I kinda wish it wasn't up to the YouTuber in his bedroom to not look at what some news site is saying and just blindly say it without checking anything they are saying. So, there has been this idea floating around, we'll call it that, that Windows 11 24H2 is dropping support for 8th, 9th, and 10th gen Intel CPUs. Now, I expect this kind of thing from Twitter accounts like Pirate Nation, which did have a post, which they have then deleted because they got community noted and a bunch of people told them they were wrong. So, you know, all's well that ends well there. But that's just a Twitter user. Pirate Nation often gets things wrong. But when you call yourself a tech journalist or a tech news outlet, I expect at least a basic level of reading comprehension. But alas, here we are. And this article here appears to be where it all started. Microsoft removes Windows 11 24H2 official support on 8th, 9th, and 10th gen Intel CPUs, posted by NeoWin. Now, if it was just one site doing their thing, you know, whatever, it's one site. But then you have outlets like Tom's Hardware, which just took what they wrote and just re-reported it. Now, following all of this being found out to be complete nonsense, they did add a note, okay? But they did originally report it with no fact-checking. Then let's go to WCCF Tech, which did the exact same thing. Again, they have made updates to the article because they didn't fact-check anything before they published it. Then we have XDA Developers, who they used a similar kind of title, but added, "Should you worry?" And they did make note that this wasn't about the users in their summary here and at the bottom of the article. And over on Overclock 3D, they used a similar title to NeoWin. They specifically mention NeoWin in their article. However, they go into detail on how this isn't actually a problem for PC builders. So, what is happening here? It is correct to say that Microsoft removes Windows 11 24H2 official support on 8th, 9th, and 10th gen Intel CPUs. However, that is not all that needs to be said, because it's not about PC builders like you and I. It's not about the regular user who bought a system a couple of years ago with a 9th gen or 8th gen Intel CPU. This is Windows 11 dropping support for 8th, 9th, and 10th gen chips for new OEM systems. Your PCs from Dell, HP, Gigabyte, the people you buy pre-built systems from. Now, technically, there is a difference between a system integrator and an OEM, an original equipment manufacturer, but the main point here is this is not a problem for your average Joe that built a custom PC, or your average Joe that bought an OEM system a couple of years ago and hasn't gone and updated it. So, how did this happen? Well, there is a list on the Microsoft official website of the supported Intel CPUs, which NeoWin conveniently links to, but didn't actually read the entire page. The processors listed represent the processor models which meet the minimum floor for the supported processor generations and up through the latest processors at the time of publication. These processors meet the design principles around security, reliability, and the minimum system requirements for Windows 11. Subsequently released and future generations of processors which meet the same principles will be considered as supported, even if not explicitly listed. So if the documentation is out of date and Intel just released a new CPU, it's still supposed to be supported. It is expected that the processor list will not reflect the most current offerings from processor manufacturers between updates. Updates to the processor list will occur at each subsequent general availability of Windows. Key point, OEMs may use the following CPUs for Windows 11 devices. New Windows 11 devices must use modern drivers, which are past Windows 11, blah, blah, blah. I don't care about any of that. But this part right here. OEMs may use the following CPUs for Windows 11 devices. If we go back to the prior version, 22H2 and 23H2, again, OEMs may use the following CPUs for new Windows 11 devices. As we can see in here, right, where are they? Here are 8th gen CPUs. If we go back to the newest version, this does not have those same 8th gen CPUs, 9th or 10th gen. And the other important thing is what it says down the bottom here. Devices with the CPUs, as in CPUs not on this list, may not be manufactured with Windows 11 pre-installed and may only be upgraded to Windows 11 by a customer. And if you're curious about the AMD side, they also have a list as well. Feel free to have a browse of that if, I don't know, you're bored and you want to look at supported CPUs. And this is important to remember. This is by no means a new practice. This is something Microsoft has basically always done, and you want them to do this. Because let's say you go to a, I don't know, maybe a less reputable PC builder, and you want to buy a new system, and maybe you're not a very technically literate person. You don't really know what a good CPU is. You don't know that 8th gen isn't the current generation. You have no idea. You just see sticker, fast, buy computer. You don't want companies to be selling pre-built computers with an 8th gen CPU, pretending like it's fast and modern, and charging modern prices for it. And this is something you will see companies like this do, because they'll have old stock, which they didn't really use in older systems, and they will want to make use of as much of that stock as possible. Having it so these can be shipped with Windows 11 is not good for the purchaser. For someone like you who knows what you're looking at, hey, that might be fine. But if you're the kind of person who thinks that Samsung is Android, you know, maybe you don't know that much about tech. But if you're building your own system and for whatever reason, maybe you got a good deal, maybe you just have some hardware lying around and you want to build an 8th gen system yourself, Microsoft is not stopping you. You can still, assuming you meet the other requirements of Windows 11, still use Windows 11 on that system. Now, there is a reasonable rebuttal here. If we go to the user-facing documentation, not the OEM documentation, the place that you come to if you want to know what Windows 11 supports, under the processor section, 1 gigahertz or faster with 2 or more cores, that would be insufferable to run Windows 11 on. That would be insufferable to run Windows 8 on. But anyway, on a compatible 64-bit processor or system on a chip. Now, if we go to this list, this takes us to Windows processor requirements. Okay, different page. If we scroll down to the section on processor requirements and go to Windows 11 version 24H2. Now you might notice these are purple. These are purple because I've clicked on the link, not just beforehand, but also in this video. So the user-facing documentation directs you into the OEM documentation. However, you would know this is not the case if you speak to literally anybody that has one of these CPUs that is using Windows right now, because they will have updated to this version, because this isn't a new version of Windows. This actually came out like a year ago in the like beta early access stuff, like Dev and Canary, and then in October for the general release. So this isn't a new release, but people are using Windows 11 on this version. And if they want to go build a new system, they can still build a new system and run Windows 11 on these CPUs. Even better yet, you can look at the supported devices that Microsoft has themselves. These are Microsoft devices. If we go down, there is the Surface Book 3. The Surface Book 3 has a, where is it on this page? A 10th gen i5 or i7, depending on what you want, and the 15-inch has a i7. This is something that Microsoft provides, and this is something that is still supported on the latest version of Windows 11. I have something else for you. Tech news outlets that did their job and didn't just report what Neoen was saying, they actually went and checked things and made sure it's correct. Here we have Windows Latest, they did a great job. Here we have TechSpot. Microsoft drops Windows 11 24H2 support for 8th, 9th, and 10th gen Intel CPUs, but only for OEMs. Now, Windows Latest did a really good thing. They reached out to Microsoft for comment. The company told me requirements haven't changed. In addition, Microsoft clarified the parent support document clearly states that the CPUs are not for consumers. Changes to the processes listed do not indicate or impact a customer's existing Windows support and are intended for OEMs to determine which processors may be used in new Windows devices, the company noted in a support doc spotted by Windows Latest. How do you, as a consumer, check if your PC is officially supported? Microsoft says you should use the PC Health Check app and not bother with the OEM documentation. Granted, you shouldn't bother with the user documentation either, because this is also wrong. So just use their app. Basically, buy a system that you don't know if is supported by Windows 11. Use the app. And then go from there. It's not a great system, but it's a system. Or you can ask people online. Asking people online. Go with that one. Go to forums. Go to places like that. And people can answer your questions. In fact, the company is also not blocking anyone from installing Windows 11 24H2 on any device, even if it's not officially supported or recommended. For consumers, you can keep using Windows 11 officially as long as you have TPM 2.0. If your device doesn't have a TPM, you can bypass the requirements by modifying the registry. Obviously, this goes outside the scope of what is supported, and there are some things that will not work. Like a lot of modern video game entity, it does require there to be TPM or working there, but you can still do it. As for the people that are not doing that, though, nothing at all has changed. Nothing. If you're a PC seller, if you're building PCs to sell to people, yes. Yes. But if you're not doing that, do not worry. Now, better yet, don't use Windows 11, come use Linux, but hey. Microsoft already has an issue getting people to adopt Windows 11. Windows 10 is EOL by the end of the year, and so few people are using it compared to prior Windows migrations. They need to fix that problem before they stop letting people use older CPUs. Good job, Windows Latest. Good job, TechSpot, for actually making sure things are happening. Now, TechSpot is basically just republishing what Windows Latest said, but at least they waited on things instead of doing what everyone else did, which is copying the Neoen article and then offering corrections after the fact, after they realized that they just said nonsense because they're not actually checking anything they write. They just see a story as like, ah, someone else reported it, therefore, my work's done here. Just for the record, I am not a journalist. I don't claim to be a journalist. I don't like using the term journalist. People who are actual journalists, who are actually looking into stories, I have respect for that. People who claim to be journalists, who don't, who are basically just doing a worse job than I'm doing. Well, but what do you think? I think everything would be solved if people just didn't use Windows, but hey, I want to know your thoughts down below. So if you liked the video, go like the video. If you really liked the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, Scrub, Silly Bear Pay, linked in the description down below. That's going to be it for me, and close the window.
What is...